Welcome back to accountancy class. We are in journal entries, and in the previous classes we have seen several kinds of journal entries, how to post the transactions in a journal we have learned, and these are some more journal entries which are typical. You try these five journal entries, how you are going to write, I want to test. Okay, you try them. First one is goods given as charity, 10,000 rupees. Paid in cash as wages on installation of machine. This is rupees 500. Goods worth 2,000 were used by proprietor for personal use. Goods uninsured worth rupees 1,000 were destroyed by fire. Last transaction received dividend of 60 paise in 1 rupee from the official receiver of Suresh, who owed us rupees 10,000 rupees. You try these journal entries. These are typical. These are different. One or two previously also you must have done, but these are new models, new kind of transactions. You try. Okay, 10 minutes time I am giving you. You try, and how you are going to come up, I want to see. Okay, so note down and try them. As a charity, first transaction, the journal entry is, what is the journal entry? Charity account debt or to purchases accounts. Charity is a loss for us. You can debit all losses and expenses, so the charity becomes a loss for us. So that is why that charity account is going to be debited. Charity account debt or to purchases account, that is the first journal entry. Second one, when we are paying wages, if it is normal wages, means wages account debt or to cash account you will mention, but you are paying the wages for installing a machinery, so it will increase the value of the machine. So that is why the machinery value we have to increase with this amount. So you should not use the word wages. The word wages you will use with ordinary payment of wages, but when they are related to a fixed assets installation, you should use this word only. So machinery account debt or to cash account you will use. See, both assets only, both real accounts, debit what comes in, credit what goes out. Cash is going out. That is why you will mention to cash account. Machinery is coming in, its value has increased. So machinery account debt or to cash account you will mention. Third one, goods worth 2,000 were used by proprietor for personal use. That is drawings. Drawings account debt or to purchases account. Next, fourth transaction, goods uninsured worth 10,000 rupees were destroyed by fire. So in that case, is it a loss for us or gain for us?
Loss.
All losses we have to debit. Debit all losses and expenses according to nominal account. So that is why what you should mention is goods lost by fire. Goods lost by fire. Account data. From where it is going to be a loss for us? Which goods we have lost? From where we are going to suffer the loss? from purchases accounts. See, just like this. See, here goods given as charity. These charity goods are from purchases. Similar goods worth 2000 were used by proprietor. From where he used? From purchases only he used. Similarly, here also, goods uninsured worth 1000 were destroyed by fire. From where we are going to lose? From purchases only we are going to lose. So that is why goods lost by fire accounted are to purchases. Did you get?
Yes, sir.
Okay. Now you see. So normally I told fixed rules. Purchases means debit. Sales means credit. Purchases returns credit. Sales returns debit. Capital credit. Drawings debit. But in these cases, purchases is going to be credited. These are exceptions. Okay.
Okay.
Did you get?
Yes, sir. Got it.
Okay. Right. See. Now the see. Received dividend of rupees 60 paise in 1 rupee from the official receiver of Mr. Suresh, who orders 10,000 rupees. See, Suresh has to pay 10,000 rupees to us, but he became bankrupt. He became insolvent. See, insolvency or bankruptcy means the person will not be able to pay his debts. He will not be able to repay his debts. In that case, the government, the court will appoint official receiver for him. See, official receiver, what he will do is, he will take his assets and he will sell those assets and he will repay the loans up to whatever amount it is okay, it is suitable, he will repay. The remaining amount will be a loss for the creditors of that person. So similarly, did you get that point?
Yes.
Did you understand? See, if a person is insolvent, if a person is bankrupt, what it implies is the person will not be able to repay his debts. Whatever loans that he has taken from others, he will not be able to repay them fully. So in that case, all those persons who gave him loans, they will fight with him. So he will approach court. Sir, they are ready to kill me. Sir, please protect me. Likewise, he will file a petition called IP, means insolvency petition. So what the court will do is, court will appoint an official receiver. So what this official receiver will do is, he is a court appointed person. So what he will do is, he will collect all assets from this fellow and he will sell those assets. And suppose his assets totally yielded 2 lakh rupees. He is able to, the official receiver is able to sell the assets for 2 lakh rupees. Whereas his loans are 4 lakh rupees. So what he will do is, to each and every person, half payment he will make, that's all. Remaining half is loss for the person who gave him loan. Did you get my point?
Yes, sir.
So here what happened was, you see, he gave 10,000, who gave him, who owed us, means we gave him 10,000 rupees, but he is able to pay only 60 paise in each rupee. So in 10,000 rupees, how many he is going to pay? He will pay 6,000 rupees. So cash, this 6,000 rupees will come to us. Remaining 4,000 is a loss for us. Did you get?
Yes, sir.
So the journal entry is going to be like this. Cash account that are, the cash, how much came to us? 6,000. See, that loss you are going to mention as bad debts account. Bad debts account that are, likewise, the term bad debts is used for any loss suffered like this, means we give loans to others, but they will not be able to repay. Okay. So in that case, we are going to use this word bad debts.
Okay.
Okay. So the amount is 4,000 rupees. Now, two, what we should write? Two. Yes, what you are going to write? Two. Yes, two. Suresh account you are going to, because he is responsible for us. He has given us 6,000 rupees. Because of him only we lost that 4,000 rupees. So debit the receiver, credit the giver. We are saying he is a personal account. So he gave us cash and he gave us loss. Both are given by him only. So that is why cash account debtor, bad debts account debtor to Suresh account we are going to mention. Did you get?
Okay. Yes, sir.
Okay. Have you noted down?
Yes, sir.
So what are the journal entries serially you read once?
Yes, sir. First one is
First one is charity account debtor to yes. What is the first journal entry? Charity account debtor to purchases account. Second journal entry, machinery account debtor to cash account. Third journal entry, drawings account debtor to purchases account. Fourth journal entry, goods lost by fire account debtor to purchases account. Fifth journal entry, cash account debtor, bad debts account debtor to Suresh account. So in the next class we will see some more journal entries.